So, opo. Secretary, siguro naman napanood nyo kahapon yung nakakagulat ano, ha, na announcement ni President-elect Bongbong Marcos na siya muna ang uupo bilang secretary. First and foremost, how did you receive that news? Ano po ang inyong reaction?
Ang unang reaction ko po ay this is a historic development in the history of Philippine agriculture. So very strategic po itong decision po ng President-elect. And I am welcoming the decision of President-elect Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr. to really personally oversee and be at the helm of the Department of Agriculture. This is the brand of political will that will be that we have been advocating since I've been here since 2019. So ang pinaka-importante nitong development na ito, Peter and Rica, yung there is political will on the part of incoming President-elect, President Bongbong Marcos, and giving topmost priority to the agriculture sector. Ito yung dapat mahalaga na bigyan natin ng pansin. At the same time, hopefully, there will be also corresponding significant budgetary support for the sector of agriculture. So for only this, I'm very happy and we will support the president.
Bagamat you welcome it, and you know, that's very gentlemanly of you, sir. Parang if you read between the lines, ang sinasabi nga po ay talagang number one, baka daw magkaroon ng food supply problems. That's one. Number two, masyado yatang, sabi ng isang alay ng President-elect, masyado daw naging masidhi ang naging problema under your leadership of the Department of Agriculture. Your thoughts on that, sir?
Well, dun sa una, Peter, ako pa nagsabi na there is a looming or brewing global food crisis at hindi tayo spared doon. Nasabi ko na ito mga 2 months ago pa. Mm. At it's now happening to some extent and it will grow in its level of severity as we progress. So, mayroon naman tayong forewarning at mayroon naman tayong action plan na pina-approve 3 months ago sa Malacanang itong plan program part 2. Mm-hmm. So, hindi po tayo nagkukulang. Yung pangalawang puntos mo kanina, hindi ko alam kung saan nang gagaling yun. So, I don't want to comment on that. There's no basis for that.
Okay. Well, if I may quote, sabi nga po, for various agricultural groups, the sector needs as its growth. Let me restart. For various agricultural groups, this is a welcome development referring to the being secretary of Bongbong Marcos. The sector needs as its growth has been severely hit by the pandemic, the African swine fever and several typhoons. Hopefully, and I quote, hopefully things will move fast. DAR buried us in a very deep grave in terms of food security. End of quote. Elias Jose Inciong, president of the Limited Broiler Raisers Association, said in a Viber message. So
let me, in general, respond to that, Peter.
Opo.
Maraming dagok ang sektor ng agrikultura. Simula nung nangyari na itong African swine fever, dumating ako, dumating na rin. Hindi ko yan kasalanan, ha. So wala pang bakuna itong African swine fever. Hanggat ngayon, 100-year-old problem of the world. So at least bumababa na yung cases. Nasa 46 barangays na lang from a high of 3,000 barangays at one time. So now we are testing vaccine developed by Thailand. So sana this vaccine will be very positive in its efficacy. Pag magkaroon yan, that will be the day that every Filipino again will be really celebrate because we can restart in a big way the repopulation of the hog industry. Dumating pa ang COVID-19. So lahat na ng sakuna dumating po during these 2 years, 10 months. At pinaka bottom line dito, Peter, even at the height of the lockdown ng COVID-19 pandemic, walang pilahan ang nangyari. May sapat na pagkain. Ang may problema lang yung walang pera na mamamayan kasi nagkaroon ng lockdowns, walang trabaho, walang pera.
Secretary, sinabi po ni President-elect Bongbong Marcos no, na isa po sa kanyang plano ay i-restructure daw po yung Department of Agriculture dahil marami daw po na, na departments under it ang hindi nagagamit. Sa tingin niyo po ba meron po talagang mga opisina na underused, undervalued na kailangan well, tanggalin?
Let me cite a number of these, Rica. Mayroon Food Terminal Incorporated na nasa Office of the President presently. So ito yung isa na hiningi po natin na maibalik under the Department of Agriculture. And hopefully this will be finally be approved. Para this FTI, Food Terminal Incorporated, will form part of a bigger food terminal system nationwide. Meron na tayong plano yan for almost 2 years now or 1.5 years we have been planning itong food terminal system. So may national setup, I mean national FTI, then may karoon kang regional, provincial, and sub-provincial or district FTIs. So yun, may cold chain facilities, lahat dapat ito. Plus logistics in general ay maganda po. Yun ang isang pagkukulang natin ngayon. Now, let me go to another part of what we need in the Department of Agriculture. We need a Bureau of Agri-Industry Cooperatives Development. Bakit? Ang ating isang pillar nitong 1DA reform agenda presently and it will be in the future is farm consolidation. Alam naman natin na very small land holdings ang Pilipinos, mga farmers. Sa rice na lang, what's the average size? 1 hectare. Do we have economies of scale? None. So we need to consolidate these farms programmatically and see to it that they will be assisted institutionally to form collective action or cooperatives or association. So in a big way, if there is one bureau that is needed now, it's a Bureau of Agri-Industry Cooperatives Development. Then another program that need proper institutionalization, itong Kadiwa. Kadiwa has been here. We resurrected Kadiwa since early 2020. We have to put this as now a regular unit of the Department of Agriculture. These are the new requirements for the new normal.
Secretary, tama po kayo, nabanggit niyo yung FTI, nabanggit niyo yung Kadiwa, nabanggit rin ni President-elect Bongbong Marcos yung NFA. Ano po? So I think you're on the same page as far as that's concerned. Ngayon, among the other things na binanggit din niya, the fact na ang Thailand at saka Vietnam have announced na hindi muna sila mag-e-export ng bigas. Ito yung traditional na pinagkukunan natin ng bigas. Ngayon, kung hindi tayo makapag-i-import ng additional na bigas at kulang ang ating aanihin, abay may problema tayo, Secretary. How do you address that?
That's why dito sa action plan po na we had it approved by the President 3 months ago, mayroon portion doon, number one action point is itong pamimigay ng fertilizer subsidy sa starting with the rice farmers, and the fertilizer subsidy must be given also to other crops farmers. Kasi mayroon ng lumabas na datos natin, Peter, to hammer this point. Itong first semester palay output natin this year ay bumaba ng 6% na. Bakit? Kasi nagbawas ang ating mga rice farmers ng paggamit ng abono. And so this is now the outcome of that practice now of lowering fertilizer usage this last semester. And that's why minumungkay po natin na dagdagan po yung fertilizer subsidy budget ng Department of Agriculture para masustain natin yung gains that we have achieved in rice production. The last 2 years, let me mention, Peter and Rica, a record harvest in rice. 92% na tayo from a level of 87% sufficiency level when I started. So there are strides that have been made, and we should continue this way forward.
Mm-hmm. Secretary, yun po, dito rin po tayo, no? Food production po yung kailangan tutukan in the next few years, kasi nga po nakikita na, at least months, kasi hindi pa po natin alam kailan matatapos itong Ukraine-Russia war. Na sinabi nga po ni incoming president, gusto rin niya ring tutukan pagdating pag siyang nakaupo na yung food production. But ang dami pong aspeto nito, we have to empower also our farmers. Yung fertilizer natin pataba, mahal, kailangan pa rin po mas maayos na mga dinhi na ginagamit para po, di ba, mas madami ang production. And even the irrigation, we also need to talk about that. Ang dami po ng aspeto ng kailangan tignan. Yun po bang malawakang macro planning magagawa po ba in the next 100 days, Secretary?
Mayroon na tayong plano, Rica. It's a matter for the President to go through these plans. My roadmap na bawat commodity industry. This is a result of massive consultation itong last 1 year. And so this is one set of documents that we are giving the new leadership, and they will go through that whether this is still possible or not. And I believe still is the base document.
Last 9 days yun na lang po, Secretary, before Paul mag-turn over. Kailan po magiging meeting ninyo with the President?
Well, upon learning yesterday yung announcement ni President-elect, ay nagpasabi ako through some emissaries na handa po tayo magbigay ng briefing to the incoming president, being the Secretary of Agriculture. So we are ready anytime.
Okay. Panghuli po, Secretary Dar, balita din ngayon na si Speaker Tito Soto, Senate President Tito Soto, nagbigay daw ng listahan kay President-elect Bongbong Marcos ng mga tinatawag nilang agricultural and fishery smugglers. At ito po ay nakuha doon sa mga pagdinig yata ng Senado, no? At you were part of the hearing, I think, no? Ang tanong po is, ito pong mga names, ito mga pangalan na binabanggit na ibinigay daw kay President-elect Bongbong Marcos, did these names come from you po or lumabas na lang doon sa pagdinig?
We had organized the Economic Intelligence Group, which is an interagency group headed by DA and DTI. So my NICA, my Bureau of Customs, and others, members there, ay galing po sa grupo na ito, Economic Intelligence Group, yung listahan.
I see, okay. So hindi ibig sabihin na natuklasan at hindi nang galing mismo sa Department of Agriculture itong mga pangalan na ito.
Ang Department of Agriculture ang chairman dun sa Economic Intelligence Group. So mayroon partisipasyon yung aming representative dun sa intelligence group.
Okay, very good. Before we say thank you, Secretary Dar, how would you characterize po your reign, your leadership, at lahat ng mga accomplishments ng Department of Agriculture during these past 6 years?
Well, I would say that the sector is now more resilient than before because of the various storms that we have gone through. We now have also laid out the solid foundation with which to grow and unlock the potential of the sector. A 10-year strategic plan is in place. First time in the history after the APMA, the Agriculture, Fisheries and Modernization Act. There is also a set of roadmaps for various commodity industries. So everything is set. It's now almost to take off.
Okay, so you're saying practically na hindi na masyadong mga problema ang Pangulo.
Uupo na lang.
Well, nandun lahat yung plano. It's a matter of really going through and strengthen if there are areas to be strengthened. Yes, we are ready to take off.